Hello everyone, it's Olumayiwa Victor Ogunshola from iDPS. iDPS means I Diagnose and Proffer Solutions. Today's video will be useful for students, industry professionals and entrepreneurs from all over the world. Why do I say this? This is because today we talk about something that has got everything to do with our personal and professional developments. Today I will be talking to us about Briggs personality types. As the name suggests, this was a theory that was put together by Isabel Briggs and her mother, Catherine Briggs. They developed their theory based on the work that was done by psychologist Carl Jung in the 1960s. Actually, they had a more concrete framework which describes personality typing. When we talk about personality typing, this shows the tendencies in which people think or act. It actually shows the broadest, most important way in which people are different. Most importantly, these differences are then sorted out into meaningful groups. For Isabel and Catherine, they developed four dimensions in which we can categorize people's personalities, with each dimension having two styles. Each dimension is asking questions. The first dimension is asking the question, how do you derive your energy? Are you outwardly motivated or are you inwardly motivated? For those that are outwardly motivated, they are known as extroverts. They derive a lot of energy when they work with others and they are able to multitask and yet achieve results while multitasking. For the other style, that is the introvert, they love working alone. This does not necessarily mean that they are shy, because when they find themselves in a working environment, they are able to deliver, they are outspoken, and they are confident. We go for the second dimension. The second dimension is asking the question, how do you process your information? Do you process your information with your senses, or do you process your information with your intuition? For those that process their information with the senses, they normally use their common sense. They like to process information using their past experiences, or sometimes they are processing information using their five senses, and they like to pay attention to facts and details. The second style for the information dimension are those that follow their intuition. These guys are usually creative, they're usually innovative, and they like to see the big picture, and they connect one picture to the other. The third dimension is talking about how you make decisions. Are you a thinker or are you a feeler? For those that are thinkers, they are usually logical, analytical, and they like to weigh the pros and cons of every action that they take. Furthermore, they are more honest, consistent, and they value fairness. For those that go with their feelings, they are those that usually empathize a lot with others. They're usually sensitive and they can be very cooperative. These guys like to look at personal values and how their personal values affect every action that they take. We talk about the fourth dimension, and the fourth dimension is asking, how organized are you? Are you a judger or are you a perceiver? For those that are judges, these guys are very strict. They like to follow rules. They like to follow plans, and they are not flexible. So they follow rules, they follow plans, they like to follow procedures, and they are not flexible. They don't usually negotiate. But for those are the perceivers, they are spontaneous, they are flexible, and they can negotiate deadlines. Those were the four dimensions and the eight styles from each dimension. You would notice that each dimension has got two styles. The dimension for energy has got the style for extrovert and introvert. The dimension for how you process your information has got those that are sensors, using senses, and those that are intuition, using intuitives. And you have the dimension for how you make your decisions. Those are thinkers and those are feelers. Lastly, you have the dimension of how you organize, and those are judges and perceivers. Let's look at the smart board. Maybe we have more clues. This is what I just explained. Yeah, you have the first dimension, how you derive your energy. You could either be an introvert or an extrovert. Yeah, you have the second dimension, how you process your information. You could either be using your senses or you could be using your intuition. You have the Third dimension, where you talk about how you make your decisions, you could be a thinker, you're logical, you use a lot of analysis, or you're a feeler, you empathize a lot with people. And the last dimension, talking about how organized you are, you could either be a judger, you follow strict rules, deadlines to the core, or you're a perceiver, you're very flexible. I'd like to also, at this point, inform us that what Mayer and Briggs propose is that each individual has one style from each of the four dimensions. So, ladies and gentlemen, which means that, for example, Victor could be an extrovert. Victor could be somebody who is using his senses. Victor could be somebody who is a thinker. And Victor could be somebody who is a perceiver. That means I would come out with the result ESTP. If you look at that, if you do it with logic, you will see that we have 16 different personality types. I'd like to encourage you in your spare time to go on and find out which of the 16 personality types that you fall into. How can you do that? The good news is that this is very free. If you go on that website, www.16personalities.com, you can have a free personality test and you can determine, are you an extrovert or are you an introvert? Yeah. Are you using your senses or do you follow your intuition? Are you a thinker or do you follow your feelings? And lastly, are you the one who is judging or are you the one who uses perception? That was the video on personality test typing from Mayer Briggs. I hope you have enjoyed that video. I'd like to get feedback from you. If you think there's something I can do better, please send an email to info@idpsconsults.com or visit our website www.idpsconsults.com. We love to serve you better. We are here to educate the world. As you know, I will not go until I talk about my passion, and my passion is that Africa must develop. Therefore, I say, are you an African in any part of the world? Keep doing everything to make sure that Africa is united and keep doing everything to promote the African unity. In English language, I like to say thank you very much. Dutch language from the Netherlands, I like to say thank you all. Yoruba language from Nigeria, West Africa, I like to say Esheo. Bye.